Hi, everybody. Woo! Well, thank you for inviting me. I have never been here before. I have a question. Let's start with a question. I saw yesterday when I was here that people, they vote by flashing their phones, the lights, so I would like to ask a question. What would you do? Would you take the red pill or would you take the blue pill? I'm going to ask one pill at a time. But before I ask, let's remember that the blue pill is this, it's us. This is reality, we think, right? The blue pill is your life today. The red pill pops the bubble. If there was such a thing as living in a simulation, the possibility of that. So I'll take a vote. Who would take the blue pill? Nobody? Flash? One, two, three. Three people, four, five. Five people take the red pill. Oh, wait, no, blue pill. Okay, so who wants to take the red pill? So everyone, a lot of people want to pop the bubble. That's interesting. I think I want a purple pill. I want a purple pill. Between these two, I want to go in and out. I like this simulation a lot. I'm enjoying it right now. So in my simulation, I think I am a creator, an inventor, and for most of my career, I have been preoccupied with the idea of escape. In the Matrix, it is about Neo's escape. And escapism has been part of our human history since the beginning. There is something innate about wanting to leave your everyday reality. One could argue that the arts, reading, books, theater, cinema, and soon immersive entertainment, they're all part of escapism. They're all part of some interest in us all to leave what's happening here and now. We want time to take our mind somewhere else besides what is happening in our lives. So 15 years ago, I worked on concepts about this idea about escaping in the Matrix. And strangely, I find myself today, to some degree, building the Matrix. I think everybody in this room, in one way or another, is actually participating in the building of the first Matrix. Now, I want to build a Matrix, but I don't want it to be a dark Matrix. I want it to be a light Matrix. I want it to be a good Matrix. It's a matrix governed by optimism, by creativity. It's a matrix that creates enlightenment and provides freedom. So in the Matrix, that story takes place 200 years from now. But it's about a simulation that runs our time today. Escaping is using your imagination to fantasize about being somewhere else. And in the Matrix, even at the time, a lot of people didn't quite understand what the messaging of the film was, because it was early days. I mean, many people were still getting comfortable with using the internet. And a lot has happened since that time. In the Matrix, there are agents, there are AIs that are surrounding us all. In the Matrix, we learned that one could beat time and space, could achieve a mind over matter, could achieve a God's eye, if you will, the ability to see anything from any perspective. And only in a virtual reality would we ever be able to do that. So perception is the next medium. Perception is what makes you believe what you're seeing. And in virtual reality, we're finding that the mind can be confused quite easily. And so, for us as designers, what we're wondering is how to create moments that put you in a state of belief and take you out of your world. In the future, our senses are going to become part of the escape. It's more than visual. It will be hearing, it will be feeling. It will be a certain sixth sense, a new sense, will take over. So here we are. It's the first matrix that we're building. Our social networks, the internet, the cloud, they are the base infrastructure of the first matrix. Soon, it will be volumetric. Soon, there will be a way to step inside that. So, I guess the question is, like Neo, whose side are you on? Are you with the machines, or are you with the revolution? Have you ever heard of Star Wars? Has anyone heard of Star Wars? Yes. So, Star Wars is a universe. Star Wars is a universe that a lot of people would like to step inside. What I am doing now in my career is I am trying to create a portal into the universe of Star Wars. Last week, we released a film here called Rogue One, and it is a new chapter in the storyline of Star Wars, and we will talk about it soon. Lastly, I'll say one thing here, that Lucasfilm, the company that created Star Wars, has created a new division. It's called ILMxLab, and it's devoted to creating immersive entertainment to create a way for people to step beyond the cinema and into the actual destinations that take place in the universe of Star Wars. And we will talk about that now in a little conversation. Conversation. Okay, let's not.
Okay, say, hey, John, you got a great speech there. I got to say, I'm Xiaoyan from GeekPark. So I think actually we'll still have some great talks and topics with a lot of speech here. So I think we still have something about your detail about what is IMxLab, what is the VR, what is not a lot of things. I think we have a lot of things. We have a lot of things to talk about here. So I know that you are the Oscar winner, right? You are the Oscar winner for the special effect. But today we think we are really, well, more than that. We will talk about something bigger than that, about the VR, about the AR mixed reality, and also about something, the philosophy about escaping the, right? This is great. I think you have a lot of great ideas. I think we can have some great sparks on it. So maybe we can have a seat there. Okay. I got a first question. You have talked about the ILMxLab, right? So, but we do really want to know what is ILMxLab. So can you tell me more about it, the details of ILMxLab?
Sure. The people who make Star Wars are called Lucasfilm. It is the company that George Lucas, the original creator of Star Wars, he created a company called Lucasfilm. Oh. And Lucasfilm writes, makes, and produces all of the Star Wars films.
Yep.
It's a very big company, and it contains a lot of amazing pieces. It has all of the writing,
yeah,
all of the concept art, all of the sophisticated visual effects, and all of the sound design, all in one company. So LucasArts has formed a new division that is purely focused on immersive platforms, so virtual reality,
okay,
mixed reality, theme park, and things of that nature, because there is an interest in evolving the way that people can get story and get inside the universe of Star Wars.
All right, that's cool. You said that you have a VR mixed reality, and you also mentioned that you have a holosim and a theme park, right? So why don't we see what you're doing real in the video? I have the video on it. So why not let's play it. 让我们放一下关于 IM 什么是 ILMxLab， 我们一起看一下他们到底做了些什么事情。Okay， 对，我们可以看一下他们在 ILMxLab 他们会做关于 VR、 AR， 还有包括关于我们。Okay， 我们看到。I
think when you get a room full of creatives from movies and video games and the technical sector, what we've got, and you get them all in the same space, you're going to create something pretty exciting.
Thanks to the coming of a new generation of Star Wars films, ILM, Skywalker Sound, and Lucasfilm itself are engaged in the creation and expansion of a universe on a scale that's never been seen before.
We've been creating virtual worlds for a long time, but when you can actually see it in front of you in real time and interact with it, to grab an iPad and drag around on the screen and instantly see the results of your creative decision, it completely changes the kinds of experiences we can make.
We're starting to push the envelope on what we think is possible to be shown in a real-time environment.
We're entering an age of immersive entertainment where it is possible to collapse the walls that separate us from story experiences. Imagine you are watching a scene, but then you were able to pass through the invisible wall that seems to separate you from that movie. You can go further into the world in which the story is taking place.
No one really knows how audiences are going to experience virtual reality and augmented reality and immersive cinema, but I do know that we have the most expansive universe to explore in Star Wars.
The trick is figuring out what storytelling looks like in that space, and part of what I'm excited about that's going on here is we're being afforded the opportunity to ask ourselves that question and explore that together.
We've created XLab as a place where we combine the story department inside Lucasfilm, ILM, Skywalker Sound, and the technology available to us to create experiential entertainment.
The mission of ILMxLab is to create completely new experiences. We're actually opening our doors now for the first time for experienced creators to collaborate with us.
I think we are experiencing a renaissance with experiential storytelling. That's something that, in a way, George did with the first Star Wars. He recognized that storytelling and technological innovation go hand in hand. And that's something that, as a company, we're uniquely suited to do.
Okay, that's cool. That's really show off a lot of things. Okay, 可以给他鼓掌，对吗? All right, it's great. Yeah, sure, a lot of the cool stuff are here, but I do still wonder, so how do XLab create contents? So how do you create contents for your XLab? Because we don't know much more about it. We just know the we know the movie you have, but I don't know how you create it.
Well, it's a very unique place to be, place to work. In one company, we have people who do all types of things necessary to create new types of content. We have people who write. We have people who paint concepts. We have people who do animation. We have people who design sound. We have people doing very advanced real-time graphics. We have people who make visual effects.
Yeah.
All of these people are within close proximity. They're all unified by the mission to tell new stories in Star Wars across the coming years.
Yeah.
We are going to make new stories seen in films, in games, in books, for the next 10 years.
Yeah.
And in planning for such an era, one needs to think about the universe and the important paths of characters and events well in advance. So we are designing what is going to be happening across the years all the time. And what XLab does is it looks at the timeline of things to come, and it is developing a path to not only see a story, but to enter a destination.
Yeah.
A destination that we might see in a film, or potentially just something that, you know, we understand about the universe as a Star Wars destination. And what our planning mostly involves is trying to understand if this Star Wars destination were a real place in the universe, how would we go about making it? What would be the logic of this place? How might a person actually enter this place, and how would story flow through this place? So development is at this time really centered around the idea that the universe of Star Wars is real, and that the destinations of Star Wars are places that people will want to visit. And once inside these destinations, story will flow through the way that stories flow through a destination here in our everyday lives. If we walk out on the street, that's a destination. And there are people walking all through it, and each one of those people have a story of their own. So there's story flowing through the real world all the time in every destination. And so we're looking at that as a sort of a philosophy, if you will, for how we will start building the foundations of immersive experiences to come.
Okay, so it just looks like that you're like in a dark night, but you are the light. You show off the people the destination on the night. You are looks like the night light to show off the destination of the in the night. And I can regard your XLab looks like a Google X or XLab for Google. You will try to explore something new and not just for the commercial products, right?
Yeah, there's really two branches of XLab. There is a lab branch, right, which is about incubating new platforms. It's about trying to understand the form of content, the form of experience, the form of story for virtual reality, for mixed reality, for theme park, immersive entertainment. And so there's a lot of prototyping on the different forms the content could take, the way the content sort of wraps you, the way you walk through it, the way you interact with it. We are building reactive places. Yep. We have reactive characters. And so there's a lab that looks at all of those things. And of course, mixed reality is very different than virtual reality. It's a sort of blending with the real world. And so there is a lot of thought that needs to be given to whether the overlapping of your reality, your world, and that of a fantasy place like Star Wars can sit on top of one another. Mm-hmm. And so there's a lot of discovery there. So that is one branch, the lab, the incubation. The other branch of ILMxLab is interested in developing and making and releasing immersive entertainment. So what we learn from our prototypes, our creative explorations, our technical explorations, our form explorations, we put into our strategies for the experiences that we'd like to make and release to everybody.
Yeah.
And so these are early days, but we are developing a slate of destinations and experiences that we will release over the years.
Yeah, you mentioned that the early stage. That's a really interesting call. We all here, we call that we are geeks. We participate in some special things. We focus on one thing. We'll do great and more than good, be great. So now we do really cares about the virtual reality that you have tried so lot, and you think you already told that it's on the early stage. But people in China especially in the internet areas, a lot of people think in the future the VR will replace all the things. Replace the cinema, replace the TV, and replace even the store. We can now buy something on the web, on the mobile app, but later in VR we also buy something on VR. So VR built everything. But what is happening? It will be a long, long ago. What do you think about it?
VR and mixed reality, they will be their own mediums, and nothing will replace the language of cinema or the experience of reading a book and using your imagination to paint the picture of the world. Cinema is a language. It's an innate language. Any person can watch cinema and make sense of the message and this sort of the language of editing in general and camera and all of those things. And it's also a place where, at least at the time being, it's a place where emotion and the human experience is best displayed.
Yeah.
Virtual reality is going to be very different. The act of watching cinema is really, it's a very immersive act unto itself. If you go to a theater and you are not distracting yourself with anything else, then you're allowing a one-directional flow of ideas into your mind.
That's right.
And you've accepted, if you go into the cinema, you've accepted to receive those ideas.
Yeah.
And that is why people who watch certain film, they have memories of those moments for the rest of their lives, right? If they have great impact. Virtual reality will be very different. We will literally walk amongst these stories and within these settings, And so our memory is going to be a lot more about where we were, the perspective we took when things happen inside of these virtual experiences.
Yeah. So, but I think it is really a two perception about the ideas about the, traditional movies and the virtual reality is totally different. One time you have director told you, look at this, look at that. But when you are in a virtual reality, there are no director. Everything, every here around you is the movie part of it. Yeah, but there one thing I'm concerned about that is the, we lost all focus on the virtual reality. We don't know which one is the truth, right? Which one is the reality? And we don't know where shall we go. But it will take a long time, maybe produce a VR movie, because you have to think about all the stuff around here, not only one direction, right? So how do you think of it? Well, in the future, it also can be the same as a traditional movie, have the same tool to do it, or it's just still hard? We don't know how to fix it or how to do it with it.
Well, I think that, again, the idea, what we're going to be building are places.
Yeah.
That they're going to be places that are going to persist for a long time. Just like in the real world, you can go to a place and that place has a history. That place could be thousands of years old. There could be towns and towns after those towns, but that place has its own history. And stories take place across time, all through time in those places. And I think that one should not really be concerned about the singular path of a singular story, but think about how story flows through a destination over time. And that once you are there and story has passed, you will still be in that place.
Okay.
You can explore that place. You could, if you wanted to, you could virtually live in that place. You could be social in that place. And so it becomes a lot bigger of an experience. That said, I do think that humans will be naturally fascinated to follow the paths of others.
All right.
And to see the see stories unfold before them.
All right.
Some of those stories, like cinema, may be performed. Mm-hmm. They could be curated. You may not even know that they are being curated.
Yeah.
And some of those stories are happening live, right? They're stories that people are making amongst each other in a place, and so it'll take a lot of different shapes. And as far as holding a person's attention, it really is going to be about the interest of that individual to try to follow what's happening. And I think it'll be an entirely different form, for us.
Yeah, I love your opinion about people will assumely be fascinated with the VR, even now that we are in the early stage. Even it's quite a different from the traditional movies in cinema, but even it's hard in this day, but people would like that because it's quite a different, it's like real, even in the early days. All right, so I got a news that you are doing a real VR movie recently. It's about Star Wars, right? It's called Darth Vader. You have the movie?
Yes.
All right. So I think we have also the video, and this video is the teaser, and it's the first time we play in China here for the audience, for the geeks. Right? Is that true? Yes, that's true. Right? 那么我们现在今天我们可以在首次在中国放映他们正在拍摄的关于星战、关于达斯维德的一个 VR 的一个视频。 大家想看吗? 声音再大点行吗? 好,那让我们来放一下我们的达斯维德,达斯维德。
dark side of the Force is a pathway to many abilities some consider to be unnatural.
Shot, but it's still a secret, right? We can know when it will release.
No. So what that is the first destination that we are building at ILMxLab. It's the place where Darth Vader lives, and where he is. Alone with his secrets, in a way that we've never seen in any of the films before.
Yeah, I mean, I think from your professional experience, it will be a really different, amazing VR experience or VR story. I think that's where it should be.
So it's new. It's a new time.
Yeah.
Almost all the VR we've seen so far have been prototypes and demonstrations.
Still in prototype.
Yes.
All right.
They've been marketing.
All right.
Right?
Yeah.
But we haven't really seen original experiences and original stories in VR yet. And what we're interested in, again, is to build a place in which there are many stories to be found and discovered.
All right.
It's not a 360 movie. That is not VR.
That's not a VR.
That is not VR.
360 movie is not a VR.
Not really.
Definitely.
No.
Okay, great.
That is a different type of experience. What I'm talking about is stepping inside of the universe of a place in the Star Wars world, and exploring that place and discovering that it is a living place.
Yeah.
Where story is happening.
Yeah, I love the word that one. You said Star Wars is a universe, right? People should go that place. I mean, especially in the VR, it's not just only the movie. It's just VR, the last thing to explore.
Yeah, so we're heading towards something. We're heading towards a hybrid form. We're heading towards universes that feel cinematic. They're very atmospheric. They have attention to detail beyond that of any game. But we are building these experiences with the technology that state-of-the-art games are made with. We're learning how to make cinema with real-time engines.
Yeah.
And what allows us to do that, you know, or what it begins to allow us to do, is to not only find story, but to set it in a reactive world, a world that will react back to you while you were there.
Okay, it's great. So I found that we talk about a VR, because it's only early stage, and then you said that 360 is not the real VR, right? Yeah, so I think that not only VR, you have AR and mixed reality, right? And also, I also got a clue that you've been announced cooperated with Magic Lips, right? That truth, right? Because Magic Leap for us in China is really, really, you know, we never know if they really have a product or what they can do. We just find some news, and most of them is about rumors. But you told me before on stage, you said you cooperate with them, you use their product, but you can't say what it is, right? It's a secret, it's a business secret. But so you experienced the Magic Leap, right? So you are the person, maybe the only one person who experienced and cooperated with Magic Leap, and you also take a video of from the Magic Leap. That's right. Yes, so probably it's also the first time we can see here in China. And and you told me that this is a real one. It's not an envisionary cinema, right? This is the video. This is the real one. Okay. So I'm so excited to see the video.
Great.
Right. Okay. 今天我们即将看到的这下一个视频呢，其实就是和 Magic Leap 和他们合作的一个小小的片段，以及上面所有的画面都是真实的，不是电影的特效。OK， 让我们看一下 Magic Leap。
Might I have a word with you, please? I regret to report that due to unforeseen circumstances, we have not yet reached the desired arrangement with Jabba the Hutt regarding Captain Solo's death. An army of stormtroopers is searching for us. It can only be a matter of time before we are blasted into spare parts. I told you it was dangerous here. We have not yet completed the mission. How did we get into this mess? I really don't know how.
Yeah, that's great. That's the from Magic Leap. OK， 我觉得大家可以今天会有一件非常有意思的事情啊，就是 John 他第一次跟我们讲到，其实 Magic Leap 他所有的这些看到的其实是真实的，刚才都是从真实的他们的产品中演示出来。 So I got really curious about that. How do you think? So how do you think the Magic Leap? So why there people don't believe them? Why there's so many rumors? What's happening with them?
Well, first of all, I would like to say that test is about a year old. A year ago, yeah.
Wow.
And okay. We did, and that's not the first test that we did with them. We've done a lot of tests with them at this
okay.
point. The earliest test that we did with them was 2 years ago.
2 years ago, they already
yeah.
had tests, right?
Yeah, just internal. That particular, what you're seeing there is actually, it is shot with a special camera system through their technology.
It's a camera, like
glass? Where the eyes are.
Our eyes.
And that is an experience that you can see through their technology in
yeah.
a room, volumetrically, and walk around it. We, last year, announced a collaboration with them.
Yeah.
The collaboration is so that ILMxLab and Magic Leap can learn about possible future forms
yeah.
of mixed reality experiences. So there's a lot of fundamental technical things
yeah.
that we need to understand how to locate and track and stick content inside of a room, how to render and serve it through the system,
yeah.
How to interact and interface with it. So there's a lot of work and research, not just for us, but for everybody,
okay.
right? In the creation of this type of content, it's complicated. And what our interest is in particularly is that we want to be able to create live experiences where you are interacting with characters.
Yeah.
And we have at ILMxLab a number of ways of doing that. We can broadcast a live performer from a motion capture stage
yeah.
into those glasses.
All right.
And have been testing that.
All right.
We yeah.
How do you feel that? Is experience great?
It's fascinating.
Fascinating.
Yeah.
Okay.
Because it's a holographic, you know, character that's aware of your presence, and that immediately starts to make you wonder what is it that you really want to do,
yeah,
right? With virtual characters.
Right. That's right.
So we have had this collaboration for some time. There is a lot of subjects that we're interested in. How this content
relates to you in your home, how it may relate in the outside world, how it may relate in a theme park.
Right.
And a lot of other things that go along with that, which have to do with content that could be persistent in your home and world.
Okay. So if there are option or you have to do choose one, VR or Magic Leap, which one do you prefer?
Well, it's virtual reality. It's not a choice, really. It's virtual reality, mixed reality, of which there's a spectrum of people participating in it.
Yeah.
We just are enjoying collaborating with the Magic Leap people because they have a great vision.
All right.
The other makers of mixed reality glasses, they are all places where Star Wars could appear, where we can create content.
Right.
But as far as it's not really a choice insofar as they're completely different experiences. But what I will say is that I do think that it's only a matter of time, years, before the two merge together into one unified piece of technology. So in my confusing earlier discussion before our conversation, I said that I wanted the purple pill. What I meant by that is what I want is an experience where I can begin completely in pure reality.
Okay.
And I would like to bring in elements little by little until I've populated my world with fantastic things and characters.
Okay.
But I would like to continue at a certain point and completely immerse. So that's from 0 to 100% to full immersion.
All right.
And I think that what in the future, I mean like maybe a decade or longer, but in the future, I think that people will create a rhythm where they will be dialing the percentage of immersive in their vision.
All right.
Based on what they want and what type of experience that they want. And I also think that it'll be quite interesting and cool when there are curated experiences in which we may walk into a location and the mixed reality will appear and slowly populate itself around you. And potentially within a singular experience, a singular curated experience, that you may find yourself at some point in the experience completely in another place.
Okay.
And then back out. So I think there'll be like this flow from 0 through to 100 fully immersed and back out again. And I think that will allow a sort of a big canvas for creatives to paint on.
Right. That's right. I think you are really picture a beautiful future of the mixed reality and the VR the thing. But there is one thing, actually, we concerned about it, where we talk about it recently. It's a little bit scared. It's about the simulation. So I still want to ask you the same questions, right? Simulation questions. Before the question, I would like to let us go into the atmosphere here. So probably we will play the video background. Let's go back to the machine control world. 我们把放一个我们在活在机器控制世界里这样一个感觉的一个视频，我们也感觉一下。 Okay. Look at that. We are living in a simulation. So there are really great question I want to ask you. Once raised by Musk, he said, 1 in billion chance that we are not living in a computer simulation right now. So what do you think? We are living in a simulation now or no? What do you think?
Well, I suppose if we're living in a simulation, the question is whose simulation is being run right now?
Okay.
So if you're out in the audience and you're watching this, this entire simulation is yours. Everything around is part of the simulation. We're part of the simulation.
We are part of the simulation, right.
We're here at the moment by some design.
All right.
To talk right now about this subject in your simulation for some reason.
Okay.
So maybe what's happening here is at this point in your simulation, we're here to give you a message to tell you that this is a simulation.
Yeah, this is a simulation to show off me, to turn right and show simulation, go there. Then to give me a clue.
So I think this is a simulation, this is my simulation.
This is your simulation.
I think it's my simulation, but I'm just saying that because it's really your simulation. But I'm saying that. I think it's my simulation. And in the simulation, I've come to China. I'm sitting here in China in my simulation. There's a reason why I'm here, and I'm not sure why that is.
Okay. But if I'm not in, I'm in or not, it seems that from your opinion, it's not important. But do you enjoy in the simulation?
Yeah, I'm really enjoying the
simulation.
In this simulation, I like what's happening to me. I like my life. So in this simulation, if I had to choose, I would choose the blue pill because I like my life, but I would like to escape sometimes. So maybe sometimes I'll go purple, I'll go towards red.
Okay. So don't even think about it. If I'm not just enjoying it. And maybe one day you finally you will realize.
So here's the thing: what I think, what they're talking about in the Matrix, what Elon Musk was referring to, is that it's almost impossible to disprove that we're not in a simulation.
Okay.
And given where technology is going, I mean, Jack talked about this the other day. We're about to reach some sort of terminal velocity where AI and the ability to create perceptual media and the fact that everybody, is so interested in escaping to that, it's only a matter of time before we build something akin to a simulation, a fantastic simulation, hopefully a beautiful simulation, an enlightening simulation, but it's only a matter of time. But what's to say, okay, let's say we reach that in 20 years, or 30 years, 40 years, what if we are able to actually build a flawless, exquisite, fantastic simulation of a universe that we want to be in. Well, okay, let's say that happened already and continued for another 100 years. Let's say it continued for 200 years. So that's when the time of the Matrix is talking about is 200 years from now.
Yeah.
So let's say that 200 years from now, they have created absolutely not only flawless simulations, but the ability to create the illusion, right, that inside your simulation you believe all of the details of your senses, that it's all part of it. So what's to say that that simulation isn't running right now from the future, right, and that this is nothing but that simulation? That it's actually far in the future and we're inside of that simulation.
Yeah.
So it's possible.
It's possible. Your answer is possible. Okay, I don't know, but actually, if we are in the simulation of the helicopter told us that it's time to over, but probably we are still in another simulation. It will life will still go on. I don't know, but it's a great talk with you. I love it. I think whatever we're living in simulation, whatever what will be in the future, VR mixed reality, just enjoy and explore it. Do it. Just like let's see what you're doing in the X Lab. Okay, thank you. Let's go back then. Thank you all.